Good afternoon. I'm not here to give any presentation on any research findings, neither to share any theory. Just to share our experience, our journey in relation to One Health. And it's really difficult to accommodate a journey of one decade into 15 minutes. I thought that after these introductory words, time will be started to count, but that already has been started. So I jumped to my presentation. You know, Bangladesh is a country with high population density. Probably it is one of the most densely populated country. And there is change in uses of land. We can notice, and the agriculture is also being intensified. Deforestation is being observed, forest land coverage is being reduced, and also the rate of deforestation is increased. And that's why the wildlife are coming in proximity of the human population. The global integrated animal production systems are also being imported. Predominating small holding farms are observed. Unplanned rapid urbanization and rapid industrialization. All these things are lead to Bangladesh to be a hotspot for emerging infectious diseases, vector-borne diseases, and also drug-resistant pathogens. And we can notice diseases among the human, animal, and ecosystem, such as avian influenza, Nipah, rabies, and so on. And with that experience of fighting against, it's better to say fighting against H5N1 outbreaks, few professional people came together and formed one platform. We usually say it in that way, that is One Health movement. We started a movement and One Health journey begins in Bangladesh. So the journey began in 2007. Most of the activities initially were done basically focusing on the advocacy and awareness building. And if you can see that most of the activities were being done by One Health Bangladesh, the platform which I mentioned, found by the professional bodies. After 5 years, actually, government came into the action. And taking government into the part, then side by side, government and also One Health Bangladesh took over the journey. I'm not detailing because I need to save my time. So most of the activities, if we target, we're focusing on the coordination among the government and other development partners, focusing outbreak investigation and surveillance, laboratory networking, and as well as One Health capacity building, bringing all multiple stakeholders on board, and organizing different conferences, seminars, and dialogues. As an outcome, it is one of the important steps for One Health Bangladesh and also the One Health journey as a whole in Bangladesh is the development of strategic framework for One Health approach to infectious diseases in Bangladesh. We started in 2011. By 2012, it was finished, but it took about 3 years to be approved by different concerned ministries. The basic focus was these strategic frameworks related to it was participatory, done by government, academicians, and also other development partners. It has been a comprehensive framework, including goals, visions, and what the components, and with specific objectives. We developed a 5-year action plan, having specific indicators in different areas of One Health. Among the 9 components, one of the important component was to institutionalize the One Health activities. And as a result, One Health activities journey started to be formalized. We had an interministerial meeting on One Health in June 2016. Few basic decisions were taken in that meeting. Number one was to establish an One Health Secretariat, and to support that secretariat, to have different kind of interministerial meeting committees, including steering committee, taking all the policy level people, technical advisory group, and also One Health Secretariat Coordination Committee. And another decision was taken that how this One Health Secretariat will run. because there was no, it's not a formal forum or any office. So it was decided that officials from three different ministries would be deputed into the secretariat to run day-to-day activities. And from that meeting, a few specific instructions were given from the secretary level. One was to deport the officers to that secretariat, develop terms of reference for different level of committees, and also to review the One Health strategic framework. So as a result, we organized one follow-up workshop to develop the terms of references of different One Health entities. As I mentioned, Inter-Ministerial Steering Committee, Technical Advisory Committee, and One Health Secretariat. And that key feature of formalization was to have strong political commitment, how to mobilize the resources, to have collective ownership, and rotational relationship. Whenever we have partners, the main problem came up, who would be the leader? So the decision was taken that the leadership would be rotational for every 3 years. So currently, Ministry of Health is taking the responsibility, and as part of Ministry of Health, IDCR, my institute, is coordinating all the One Health activities. And as in addition to that, to have functional partnership, effective coordination, and definitely combined action focusing different aspect of activities. Next concern was that how to mobilize the resource, how can this One Health Secretariat will be run. So we have one resource mobilization meeting in December 2016. We invited all relevant stakeholders, including ministries, representatives from the ministries, and also development partners. And in that meeting, we got commitment from different partners. Basically, the main resource we have successfully obtained from Ministry of Health for next 5 years fund is being secured by Ministry of Health. And in addition to that, USAID PNR and Food and Agriculture Organization and other development partners also committed to provide support to One Health Secretariat, including human resource or day-to-day program support. Then after that, in March 2017, the first Ministerial Steering Committee meeting was held, and then in that meeting, the terms of references were approved, and after that, the One Health Secretariat started to function formally. So for One Health Secretariat, it's about a year journey. These are different areas where One Health Secretariat is functioning. In short, if I want to highlight the activities we have done in last 1 year, one of the important activity to revise the One Health strategic framework. To do that, PNR recruited one consultant for that, and having going through the literature review and different series of workshops, we have revised that strategic framework, and that is currently under, has been submitted for government approval. The revised strategic framework actually expanded its area in terms of, in our initial vision statement, we have focused only disease, but in current strategic framework, we have included other conditions also. And also, we have included two different departments. Initially, Ministry of Health, Ministry of Fisheries and Livestock, and Ministry of Environment and Forestry were there. All the Ministry of Fisheries and Livestock were there, but practically, fisheries involvement of fisheries was little less, but in our revised framework, we have included Ministry of Agriculture and also Department of Fisheries. We had One Health Planning and Performance Workshop to review our journey to evaluate, we can say kind of evaluation, and that has been done with the support of PNR. This is one kind of picture we can see regarding our status. So you can see that in terms of leadership, One Health Bangladesh scored quite an impressive score, but in monitoring evaluation, we have a lot of to do. We organized zoonotic disease prioritization workshop in July 2017 with the support of USCDC and also USAID PNR. These diseases were identified as prioritized zoonotic disease in Bangladesh. We did few capacity building activity We organized two training, and this year one training was just basic training on One Health, where young scientists joined there, those who have all just started their career. And then another training we have organized, which is focusing the scenario-based joint outbreak investigation. We have started to have joint anthrax surveillance and also joint outbreak investigation and response, but we are yet to formalize that. We have started to print one publication, One Health newsletter, and we published first issue of that. Second issue is pending, and I can invite everybody in this house, if you want to publish your any kind of One Health paper, please send to us. The next step, which we are focusing, I already mentioned that we have started joint outbreak investigation. We have currently what happened when a outbreak, zoonotic disease outbreak happens, we send separate teams from separate ministry. But we are planning to have one health rapid response team, which would be situated at One Health Secretariat. And from Environmental Ministry, they have already mentioned the members of the name. We have name from the Ministry of Health also, and awaiting from the names from in Ministry of Fisheries and Livestock. So after having those group, we will have established One Health rapid response team. We have started to initiate anthrax surveillance in collaboration with Department of Livestock. Initial paperwork has been done, but yet to move further. As I mentioned that we are getting budget from Ministry of Health, we are yet to obtain budget from other ministries. So that is our next step to work on. We have to continue our advocacy work, because frequent changes in the leadership we can observe. So the policymakers need to know about One Health. Whatever success Bangladesh has seen because of good advocacy work that has been done by One Health Bangladesh. And definitely capacity building in all partners is required to have successful One Health program in Bangladesh. Finally, One Health Secretariat work has been government-led now. And also we have got commitment for sustained funding, although it's limited, but it is secured for 5 years. So that is one kind of achievement we can see in One Health issue. Although it's not totally sustainable, but we have started our journey to be sustainable. We acknowledge all the support from our development partners, especially EcoHealth Alliance, because they have supported me to come here and to give me opportunity to speak before you. Thank you very much. And I finished 2 minutes earlier, so I will get that time later on. Thank you very much.